Hi, this is Shad with lovetocode.com. Welcome back to another tutorial on Java JDBC. In this video, we will learn how to use ResultSet Metadata. For this tutorial, we will use the following table, Employees. The table already has sample data for testing. I have a SQL script that creates the table and adds sample data. You can download it from the link below. The file is sql/tablesetup.sql. ResultSet metadata can give you information about your result set. So to get started with database metadata, you must first retrieve it from the ResultSet object. This is accomplished by calling ResultSet.getMetadata. Then once we have the ResultSet object, we can call methods on it to get the column names and types, also check to see if a column is auto-increment, and also if a column is nullable, and so on. There are a lot of more methods available. See the Javadoc for details. Alright, so let's go ahead and switch over to Eclipse and see this in action. I have a very simple program called ResultSetDemo. In this program, what I'll do is I'll first start off by getting a connection to the database. Then I'll create a statement and I'll execute a query. So in this example, I have select ID, last name, first name, salary from employees. Then once that query is executed, I retrieve the ResultSet metadata. Now that I have the metadata, I can get information about it. So the first thing I'd like to do is get the actual column count, and that's the number of columns that we have in our query, and we display it. Then I'd like to do a for loop and get information about each column. So remember in JDBC, all columns are one based. So we start our for loop at the position one, and then we move up to the column count. So the next line here, I'll print out the column name. Then I'll print out the column type name, and so this will give me the database specific type name like varchar, int, or decimal. I'll also check to see if a column is nullable. This will return a certain code if that value is set accordingly. And then I'll also check to see if a column has auto increment set. This returns true or false. And then that's pretty much it for the for loop. So here's the output of the application. I can see that we have four columns that were returned, and this matches up with the query that we submitted. And so we have the information for the first column, ID, it's an int, it's not nullable, and auto increment set to true. Last name's a varchar, it is nullable, auto increment set to false. A similar thing here for first name. And then finally, we have our salary, the column type is decimal, it's nullable, and auto increment is set to false also. So this looks pretty good. So what I'd like to do right now is move over to the MySQL tool and just verify some of this information. So here's the actual database schema for the employees table. The first thing I'll look at is the ID column, and we can see that it's of type int. It's a non-nullable and also auto-increment, and it's the primary key for the table. We also see that we have last name, first name, those are varchars, as was shown by the application. And also for salary, we see it's of type decimal. So this really matches up with the information that was presented by the actual Java program. And the ResultSet metadata class, they have additional methods where you can get more details about it. But this is enough information to get us started with ResultSet metadata. Well, that wraps up our discussion on using ResultSet metadata with JDBC. Please subscribe to our channel to view more videos on Java. Click the thumbs up to like our video. Also, visit our website lovetocode.com to download the Java source code used in this video.